When people are starting out in their business as doers, as technicians, they're working 100% in their business and almost nothing on their business, right? They had that entrepreneurial seizure, and that entrepreneurial seizure took them maybe 5% of their time or something like that. And then they forgot about it, right? And they're now consumed by doing in their business. But really, as a solopreneur, you want to get to the point where you're working 50% on your business and 50% in your business. So the end part is the technician, the doer part. The 50% that's on the business is comprised of the entrepreneur and the manager. And as the entrepreneur, probably about 15% is the entrepreneur, and about 30%, 35% is the manager, is really how it ought to work out strategy-wise in that intermediate mode where you're growing the business and you're trying to get out of it, okay? And then to get to your level, the 100% on the business, that would be when you're just doing the entrepreneur and the manager role, and you've got enough people in the business that they're doing the business for you.
Right, so, that makes sense.
So that's kind of the growth path that I see there.
Right, so you kind of graduate from being the doer to where you have doers, but you've built the systems and the processes for them to do the work at the quality that you expect as a manager. And then you've got that entrepreneurial where you're continuing to drive the business forward, but then continuing to kind of shift to that entrepreneurial focus so that you can basically take your business to that whole nother level that you didn't even perhaps envision when you started, sometime in the past.
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's the dream where you sit on the beach and you work 4 hours a month in your business, right?
Right.